Hello everybody, this is ManOS and welcome to another Eternal news video. It's finally time to catch up on the latest balance changes that dropped, I think, yesterday, if I remember correctly. So before we dive right in, you know the drill. Hit the subscribe button down below for future Eternal news. And before we dive into the balance patch, I briefly want to introduce you to today's sponsor. Today's video is sponsored by NordVPN, one of the leading virtual private network providers out there. A virtual private network keeps your data secure and yourself anonymous while using the internet. NordVPN comes with super fast servers, allows you to unlock your favorite entertainment websites like Netflix. They provide a 30-day money-back guarantee. They also have an included cybersecurity suite, which acts as an ad blocker to boot. They don't lock any of your data, provide a 24/7 customer support, and you can use it on up to 6 simultaneous connections, so one account covers most or all of your electronic devices. And most importantly, they don't have any bandwidth limit, so you can use it non-stop without it getting throttled, which is particularly important for heavy users like us. It also won multiple awards and comes highly recommended by top technology experts. So if you're still surfing online without a VPN, now is the time to change that. Get NordVPN now, 70% off for a 3-year plan, including 1 month extra for free using the code ManOS or the personalized link in the description down below. And now on to today's content. All right, so now time for the balance patch. So there are a bunch of nerfs and buffs in this balance patch. First off, there's finally a change to Even-Handed Golem. A lot of people have been calling for it and waiting for it, and it's kind of an interesting change. They just basically made the body matter less, which is an interesting way, and that also actually impacts the shenanigans with Shadowspire that people have been playing, because now you can't bypass the Even deck by just playing sort of a regular deck if you pay attention to cost versus attack stats on units, and you could play like merchants, for example, and then you just get a Shadow Spire on turn 3 with your merchant, and on turn 4 you swap all your odd cards into even cards with Shadow Spire and turn on your even-handed golems. And that doesn't really work anymore now, because even-handed golem itself now becomes an odd card, so that's another nice side effect here. And it obviously weakens the card, because now a 1-1 is just not really much impact anymore. As they say here, it's a big difference between like a 3-4-1 and a 2-4-1, and it's a lot harder to turn it into a full 3 cards now, and it keeps the core power and functionality of the card intact while just giving it more weaknesses. And in general, I really liked this balancing philosophy by Direwolf in the past, so we'll see how it plays out, and I think it's an interesting approach, and there's still potential to just take further action if that isn't enough. Next we have Nahid's Distillation, which now costs effectively 5 or 7, which I think actually makes it pretty bad. It's a bit better than Swindle now, but we all know Swindle, for example, is not a great constructed card. This is better, but not by a lot, and I don't expect it to see much play anymore. It might be still okay as like a market card or in certain decks that absolutely need it, like some control decks, but yeah, all in all, I think the card is just not going to be particularly relevant anymore going forward. The change in cost by 1 is just very massive. But then again, there's not really much you could do about how you change the card, I guess. Otherwise, so it makes sense. Then Kaido finally got toned down. Now it takes 12 units to make an 8-8 instead of 10, which is one of the more likely changes that I expected them to make. And also they made increased the corrupted cost to 2, making him more of a like, yeah, tempo commitment to turn the corrupted, the nightmare unit into an 0-1 or later into an 8-8. The 8-8 part isn't much affected by it, but like in the early game where you just don't have use for the shade right away, but also don't want to use the body, you could just spare 1 mana a lot of the time fairly easily, but now 2 is a big deal. For anyone that has played more with, for example, Two-Face, notice how big the difference between 1 and 2 on Corrupt is. Then Unfamiliar Interloper got changed from a 1-2 to a 1-1. General health changes make Crafted units notably weaker because the shade dies faster, means less jump blocking, less opportunity to have a good turn where you can sack it without messing up your turn. It just kind of was tying things together a bit too good in these like 3, 4, 5 faction decks, even in Expedition, so I like making the card weaker. It still does the same job, but it's much weaker at that specific job because it's much less of a card past the fixing. It also doesn't hold off random small stuff anymore and so on and so forth, so that's a pretty sensible change, I think, to a card that otherwise doesn't have much negative impact by being changed, so it's kind of like a minimally invasive change. Then Rectifier, especially in Expedition, has been a bit too good in these decks and had a bit too much impact for also being two silences effectively, and was very easily splashed, and now it costs double time, so the commitment is higher, and also is a 1-1. Not sure if the stat change was necessary in addition to the color change. I think making a double time alone already would have been a pretty reasonable change, because it was just a bit too easy to have a good silence effect otherwise in a lot of these decks. Next, we see Aramot's Machinations now cost 6 and double time and double shadow, so it's also not easily splashed. We had a fair share of decks that were just like 3 faction with like a Shadow Sigil and Interlopers just marketing Machinations. Now you can't splash it, and it's also a lot less efficient. I think it's reasonable because the card was really powerful, and it's still pretty powerful, but not that appealing anymore. So makes a fair bit of sense, especially with a lot of the new cards we got, like Jack and Supplier with Machinations, just disgusting. And then Salvo now doesn't just deal 2 damage to a unit, it also deals 2 damage to yourself. But yeah, they felt like they were a bit too good relative to the other ones, which makes sense. This was way better than any of the other market spells, both in which casting cost it could get, and also its like front side effect, so to speak. Now it's much higher opportunity cost, and also better in aggressive, the more aggressive you are, and worse the less aggressive you are, which is a bit weird. Like, I'm not super happy about these market cards being heavily balanced towards one side of the deck spectrum over another. I prefer the market cards to be similarly good in all kinds of archetypes, because every archetype sort of needs them. So I would prefer all market cards to be kind of sort of generic in the sense of how good they are in a given archetype. But it's a reasonable way to change the card, just a bit unfortunate. I also never liked how Aurelian Merchant got shifted so heavily towards a reactive controlling card, making it really awkward for more proactive time decks, for example. And this is kind of the opposite, just in fire. And Ark of Sol was a bit too good, too much of a free roll, especially with Crack the Earth. So they nerfed it, and now it costs 2. It's still a pretty solid card, given how free it is. But now it's a bit more of a like time commitment, tempo commitment to use. So not something that I necessarily expected, but certainly reasonable from like how good a free roll market Ark of Sol was in a lot of decks. Then we got a bit of a side grade here. Purge Driver is now a 3-2, but costs triple justice, and 2 Phase is now a 2-1, but costs 1 for the corrupted ability. I would say actually like 2 Phase is not really a side buff, it's like a notable nerf, given that 1 health is a big difference. First of all, the shade now is a 1 health, and second of all, the 1 health is just a big deal for the body, and the 1 cost on the corrupted isn't even that relevant in a lot of cases, so that card is a lot worse now. It was a pretty nice universal thing for a lot of decks, and now it's a pretty underwhelming card, honestly. And then we have some buffs, some pretty neat ones. Kira the Prodigy, a bit more robust and doesn't die to Blazing Salvo anymore, and scales even better with stat gain now, as a 2-cost 2-3, so that's pretty sweet, especially in Expedition. Elon Blade now is a 4-4, which is amazing. The card is really good now, just a matter of like what best to do with it, because it's like not that easy to find the right home for it, but I think a 2-cost 4-4 weapon is amazing, in a especially in a world where sacrificing unit can be an upside or at least not much of a downside. Then aerial battle now is fast and deals 7 to each unit with flying. That's a pretty weird buff. Like, the card still is probably not going to see any play, like, even in markets, I think. Then we have Staff of Stories has been reverted to its former glory of ages ago of 5 armor, which is reasonable, but probably not that consequential these days. Maiden has also been reinstated, which is nice, and the card is really great and looks really, really good right now with a lot of the, like, throwaway unit stuff going on. So that card will sure make a comeback, at least in markets, possibly also in main decks. And Midnight Gale got the much desired fourth health that people wanted, a lot of people wanted on that card for quite some time, and that makes it actually a really nice 3-drop now in proactive Feln mid-range decks, especially given that after the first time with Lifesteal, it's actually a force to be reckoned with, and now a lot harder to deal with at 3 health and at 4 health and 4 attack. So no Suffocate, no Torch, no Seer, all that stuff. So there's, like, Open Contract and Defiance as two of the more noteworthy ones. Annihilate also doesn't work. Desecrate is pretty bad these days. So is Vanquish. So it's pretty limited, actually, in how you can best deal with it. I guess Permafrost is a thing in Ice Bolt. But yeah, the card got quite a lot better and is pretty cool. It was always pretty decent, but falling a bit short. But I think the fourth health point should do a lot on that front. And then there will also be a draft update coming, with 73 commons and uncommons that will be added to the format to shake things up, both in draft and in expedition, but that will be a separate article and potential separate video. All right, so yeah, quite a bunch of changes. A bit surprising changes, like no changes to any of the Shadow of the Spire cards, which I sort of expected that might happen, because, like, Supplier and Jack seem so pushed. And even Ikaria is pretty pushed, but, like, as long as Supplier and Jack are a thing, like, we don't even need to talk about Ikaria. They really push the boundaries, like, a lot with Shadow of the Spire. So, yeah, we'll see if there will be future nerfs, like, after the Throne Spring Championship, for example. So we'll see how that goes. So yeah, let me know in the comments down below how you feel about these new cards and balance changes. So, yeah, you have my take. What's yours, and how do you feel about my take? As usual, before you leave, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Turn on the notification icon, leave a comment, share it with your friends. Whitelist YouTube on your adblock or turn off your adblock to help support your favorite content creators. And yeah, check out the VPN sponsorship deal in the description down below, as long as it is around. All right. That's it again for this time. I'm your host, Manu S. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.